Atlas, I accept this message.
Up some other time, Lernie, as I'm in a bit of a rush.
I'm empty.
Still there, are you?
I am indeed. To the top. More splitters. Accept this spear. Extra pointy. Thank you.
spent so much of my short life alone, but now... this experience where for eternity, all I've to think on is a few bright glimpses that I spent with him, not by myself.
Although... he's just as obstinate as ever, isn't he? Always refused to budge. He ever tell you of the war in which we fought? I fought, I should say. He could have ended it, but he refused to take up arms.
Achilles hasn't been particularly forthcoming about his mortal days, no. So he wouldn't fight. I've heard that mortals sometimes frown on that, but why should he have fought if he didn't believe in the cause?
He shared our cause. So what if it was not completely his? If not for his stubbornness, I would have come here just a bit later, I think.
He blames himself for what happened to you, you know. I figured he failed to defend you or something, not that he didn't fight at all. Although he said something about how, once you died, he shortly followed in a rage.
I wouldn't know a thing about that, stranger, for you see, I was already dead. Getting my place here in the afterlife all sorted out took quite some time, getting accustomed to all this.
Thanks a lot. Shall we, sir?
It would seem that the time for additional fun has arrived.
Ah, yes, my favorite pastime. Getting butchered by a giant double-bladed axe, and sometimes trampled.
Then good. You have much to enjoy in store.
I accept this message.
Ah! eat.
Zesty.
For me to side against myself, why, that would make no sense at all.
He won't stand for this. Let's give him a show then.
Damn it, one's come back.
Back there, water under the bridge. What say you, nephew?
The power of the sea.
Come on.
pay for that.
You again?
Waste not more words with this one, King. Let's fight. Except for last time, I hope, my good shade. Cerberus is patiently at work instead of resting here.
One more stop. Of the pact. sharpened my senses.
Cousin, so take heart. Eternity awaits you once you finally break free.
A fine catch. Just what I need. Pom power. I bet it's in here. Thank you. is already. Oh, what is this stuff? Good enough to eat. Time to deliver the goods. I can use this. Fight some satyrs or get out of here. What's in the pool this time? Should come in useful.
From me, I swear. A little way to stave off competition masquerading as the wisdom of a sage. Those stupid mortals will buy anything.
Should be able to get back through here. Got this delicious sack of meat. Take it.
After deliberating briefly, Cerberus concludes that yes, he shall accept the sack.
Thank you, boy. Here goes. I'm back, Father.
Why? Why do you keep showing up? In spite of knowing that the outcome shall be just the same as how it always was.
Beats having to toil away under your overbearing supervision. And besides, as you may be aware, I've recently made up my mind to leave this place.
Yeah, utterly incorrigible. When next we meet here, then we'll keep it brief. I've grown weary of our aimless conversations. Now prepare.
Exactly why.
Cousin. How is this possible? That this... My strength fails.
In the name of someone very sore right now. The sun.
You're back?
Mother. You can't do this to me, Mother. You said Father is no fool, and neither are you. There has to be a way to fix this. Not just with you and Father, but with everyone. There has to be a way.
You have your father's stubbornness. Listen to me. You're endangering everything you care about by coming here. Don't you understand? Besides...
What? Besides what? Tell me, please.
The truth is that I like it here, Zagreus. I have done well for myself on my own. And your father, he has his domain to look after. The feelings he once had for me... Feelings we shared. They fade with time. You'll understand someday.
No, I won't be understanding anything of the sort. Father still loves you, I'm sure of it. And he owes you an apology, damn it. I cannot make amends with you on his behalf. Something only you can do together.
What do you mean he still loves me, Zagreus? How would you know?
Because... I'm his blasted son, that's how I know. But trust me isn't ever good enough, I know that too. I'll prove it to you, Mother. Just you wait and see.
Oh, you're fading, son. You don't need to prove anything to me. Please don't do anything rash. All of us made our choices. Now we have to live with them. Isn't it enough to know that I'm safe? That I'm content to be alone?
No. It's not enough for me, because this blasted family... It cannot just keep hiding from its problems, running from them. We're stuck with one another. We have to do everything we can for one another.
Oh, my dear boy.
We have to. No, not yet. God damn it all. Again.
Well.
Hey, Hypnos. This is for all the well-meaning advice you've given me. A little something from a certain double-bladed axe-wielding, bull-headed, oversized monster of a man you admire.
What's this? It's kind of hard to read the handwriting. It says, no way. To Hypnos, my biggest fan. Stay vigilant. Asterius. There's even a little picture of a bull. Wow!
Enjoy it, Hypnos.
Cerberus acknowledges the prince with an affection tempered well with time.
Thank you.
hits the spot, doesn't it, boy? I know you're caught up in the middle of all this and having to weigh your loyalties more than you'd like. I'm sorry we're putting you through this.
The Underworld Prince's next attempt to bribe the monstrous triple-headed hellhound into further liking him proves once again successful, as the kingly gift of heavenly ambrosia is beyond compare.
Achilles, I need your help.
What is it, lad? What's wrong? What can I do?
Let me in Father's chambers, please.
That's high atop the list of things I'm not to do for anyone and under any circumstances. What is it you need? I've never even been in there myself.
I don't know. I don't know, but if I know Father, and I think I do, he's got to have something of hers in there, of Mother's. She still doesn't get it, doesn't believe me about him, and I said I'd prove it, that he cares for her.
All right, slow down, I understand. Look, this can get me in a lot of trouble like you've no idea. And not just me, so be careful and be quick while he's still out. Take this and go. Don't leave anything there out of place, all right?
Thank you.
The stoic lord and master of the house possesses wealth beyond imagining, a portion of which he has used for a crisp set of attire for every passing day.
I knew it. It's just capes.
In his lord father's very private chambers, Zagreus, the lock-removing prince, discovers a most delicately painted likeness of none other than Persephone herself. A coat of dust suggests it has remained here for some time.
He's never stopped thinking of her. Oh, what a fool.
What you need.
I did, thank you. Just thought I'd say hello.
Something you need from me? What are you doing here? I heard you finally made it out. What, did you break out of here only to die in some pathetic way on the surface?
Long story, but yeah. Boils down to what you said, more or less.
So you're going back out there again? Well, it's your business, not mine. For your sake, I hope it's worth it.
It is. Dusa, in my father's chambers, he has a bedside portrait of somebody. Is she someone with whom you were familiar?
Oh, Prince, I'm not permitted in your father's chambers. Are you kidding me? I'd ask you what it's like in there, but I don't think I'm supposed to know.
Don't worry, you're not missing much. What you will with these, my good chef. Till next time. Maybe Nexus with chaos.
What's the good word?
No way I'm lifting these. Shield.
Pretty scary stuff out of there.
Zagreus. You're no mere weapon, are you? My aspect of Axigriff feels even stronger. Care to join me out there?
I still don't get what that's supposed to be.
Should be simple. Bye, everyone.